Today we're going to take a look at a superior ancient wheat that you can actually make healthy bread with. And this will give you knowledge that 90% of the people out there know nothing about, right after the channel intro. Remember, you are ultimately responsible for protecting yourself and for providing for yourself. Live your life with honor and integrity, and always be the wolf hunter. Don't be the sheep, and never be the wolf. Welcome to this community. I'm an avid prepper and oath keeper, and I'm certified to teach firearms and the use of deadly force through my state's police academy. If you want to learn true prepping skills instead of just seeing another gear review channel, and if you want to learn how to protect yourself and also how to keep yourself out of jail should you have to protect yourself, then please subscribe to this channel. So the majority of people out there have never even heard of Einkorn wheat before, and I hadn't even heard of it myself until just a few months ago. Einkorn wheat is an ancient strain of wheat that traces back to when man first began harvesting wheat for food. This stuff is so old it's been traced back to right around 7,500 years before Christ. So I had already shot a video of how to make a simple bread during SHTF, and I used Einkorn wheat in that video. And in that video, I talked about the Einkorn wheat that I was using, but I was afraid that both talking about the wheat and also showing how to make the bread all in one video would just make this video too long, so I decided to cut it into two shorter videos. And by the way, wheat kernels are actually called wheat berries, even though they look nothing like berries, so you'll hear me refer to them as wheat berries in this video. So in today's video, you get to watch me mill the wheat berries down into a fluffy flour, and also hear me talk about how the stuff is superior for your body than today's wheat. And then in an upcoming video, I'll show you a simple bread recipe where you can make some really kick-butt bread that's actually healthy for you during SHTF. So this is my understanding of the difference between today's modern wheat and the ancient Einkorn wheat. Today's wheat is hybrid between several types of grain and grasses, and by doing this, this has allowed our modern wheat to have a higher yield and be less susceptible to drought and other things. But in the process of doing this, it's robbed our wheat of many of its nutrients and has changed the way the gluten in that wheat affects our bodies. So today's modern wheat, it basically changes quicker into sugar in your body than the unmodified ancient grains did. Basically, Einkorn wheat is supposed to actually be healthy for you. It's going to give you more of the good stuff and not just basically turn into sugar inside your body once you eat it. So if you're on a low-carb diet and missing bread, research this Einkorn wheat and make your own informed decision if this could be something that you could incorporate back into your diet again, obviously within reason. Now I have to give one caveat about this wheat. While it's my understanding that regular, dried, modern wheat will store for decades, if stored in Mylar bags with oxygen absorbers or if stored in number 10 cans, like these one I regularly buy from the Bishop Storehouse. So while it's my understanding that regular, modern wheat will store for decades, I do not know how long Einkorn wheat will store, even if it is stored in the same Mylar bags or the number 10 cans. But my suspicions are that it will probably store just as long as today's wheat, as our ancestors used to store it for quite a long time themselves. So I'm going to slowly, as my budget permits, get more of this Einkorn wheat and store it in the Mylar bags with the oxygen absorbers. And then I'm going to test it out every several years to ensure that it is storing properly. Now, while I've already got several hundred pounds of wheat that I've bagged myself and also bought in the number 10 cans from the Bishop Storehouse, my goal is to end up with several hundred pounds of each now, both of today's wheat that I've already purchased and then also with the Einkorn wheat that I will purchase in the future. Now you may ask why you can't buy bread at the grocery store made from Einkorn wheat, and it's my understanding that since this stuff isn't a hybrid wheat, that it doesn't last as long on the store shelf once it's been ground or milled and the shell has been broken. But just one more really super quick note about this Einkorn wheat before closing the video. The stuff is supposed to be good enough that I've heard, again, heard, that people with mild gluten intolerances are supposed to be able to eat Einkorn wheat without the same side effects that they would suffer if they ate some bread from today's modern wheat. When I first started hearing about people who had gluten intolerances and couldn't eat bread. At first, I just thought that they had weak bodies or had some made-up illness. But now I'm starting to believe that maybe there's nothing actually wrong with them. That maybe their bodies are just rejecting the near poison that our society is calling food nowadays. So folks, please keep an eye out for the video where I actually make the bread. It's a simple recipe that you should be able to make even if SHTF happens and you don't have access to a bunch of the ingredients that normally goes into bread. And the bread that I made tasted great also. It tasted just as good as any whole wheat bread that you may get as an appetizer at a fancy restaurant. Anyways folks, if you made it this far, hey, thank you very much for watching, and I pray that you have a good night.